Hey everyone, my name is Adam Beers. I'm a volunteer here at 180. I'm also a youth pastor down in Miami as well. I'm from Maryland. I'm not originally from Miami, but I love this city and I've loved getting to know you guys. One thing about me, I have a decent sized family. I've got a twin sister. I've got two older brothers, both who live up north, and my sister lives all the way up in Maine, and I miss them dearly. So the way that I became a Christian is a lot like a lot of other people. I grew up in the church from a really, really young age, so I always knew about Jesus. I always knew what was right, what was wrong, what I was supposed to do. But I always had this desire to not do that. And so when I graduated high school, I was 18, and I ended up doing everything I knew I wasn't supposed to do. Started doing different kinds of drugs, started drinking, ended up moving in with my girlfriend and sleeping with her. And I just was really far away from the faith that I knew was right and the God that I claimed to believe in. And I honestly, I didn't care for God. I didn't want anything to do with him. And it was, you could tell by the way I was living my life. But one night when I was 19, God just started convicting me of my sin and how far away from him I was, and showing me that I had pretty much turned my back on him. I'd given him the middle finger and didn't care about him. But in the same moment, he showed me that he loved me, and he showed me that he wanted to have a relationship with me. And from that point on, he changed my life. And my life from that point on wasn't perfect. I was still doing a lot of things. I was still smoking weed. I was still living with my girlfriend, but what God was doing was changing me, shaping me to be somebody else. So when I was 19, when I mentioned that God started doing something in my life, I was actually at my job. I wasn't in a church. I wasn't around Christians telling me the gospel. I was actually at my job. And what started happening was just conviction. God inside me started showing me the reality of who I was, my sinfulness, and how far away I was from him. And from that point on, he started drawing me to him. I didn't know really anyone who to go to. All I knew was this pastor who I'd met a couple months ago. And so I called him up and he started talking to me about God. And he got me to read the Bible. And when I read the Bible, it was like for the first time in my life, I saw truth, and I saw the truth of who God is and who I am. And I found out and realized that he loves me, despite the things that I've done in my life, despite me running away from him and just turning my back on him, he still loved me and that he wanted a relationship with me. When I was 18, I began smoking weed. It started mostly just out of curiosity and seeing what it was about. I was around people who were smoking weed, and so I started doing that as well. When I was 19, I became a Christian. So the desire to smoke weed and the desire of loving God and being a Christian were now conflicting with one another. And really it was a battle between who was gonna win. Was I gonna go to weed or was I gonna go to Jesus? What Jesus was showing me in my life was that my curiosity with weed is what started it, but I became not clearly addicted, but dependent on weed. And I would go to weed when I was stressed out or when I just wanted to forget about life or just have a good time. And so I couldn't really picture a good time without being high. But through that, Jesus showed me that my love for weed was greater than my love for him. And really that weed didn't love me. And I was depending on it instead of him. And so through that time, Jesus just began to work in me and draw me closer to him, show me that weed was not helping my relationship with him. It was really pulling me away from him and I needed to give it up. And so through the power of God's grace, I was able to now be 2 years free from being high. And I thank God for that. My name is Adam, and I am loved.